Hello friends, so welcome to this new episode. In this episode we will discuss about user selection parameter. So what is the user selection parameters? Selection parameters or the selection criteria are defined for searching SOA messages which are monitored under the T-code SRT_MONI. So what is the purpose? We know that we are transferring so much messages between the master data governance system to the target system, and we are also receiving messages from the target systems into master data governance system. In some cases, we came across a situation where we wanted to search these messages based on certain parameters. For an example, if it is a product master, we wanted to search these messages based on the product ID, division code, material type, or plan data, or any parameters you can name it, which exist in the XML structure. It is not limited to the product master. You can of course use it for the business partner, financial objects, and also the custom objects, or any messages which are monitored under the T-code, SRT_MONI. Only catch point here is, you know, in some cases for the complex structures, it won't work. So you need to check with SAP. Apart from that, there are customers who are using a framework for, you know, the message handling. In if you are the one, then we will create a new episode later. There we will discuss how to define the user selection parameters. Basically, you need to do some custom developments. But in this episode, we will discuss only about the messages which are monitored under the T-code SRT_MONI, and we will see how to define the parameters. So let's go into the system and do the configurations together and see how it works. Go to T-code SOA manager and click on the monitoring tab and click on the user defined search, and then search if there is a search already exist or not. There is no search exist, then you can click on the create button to set up a new search. Enter *MDM*, and then you have all the interfaces. Now you can configure this user defined search for whichever interfaces you want. So for you know, in this case I take this one as an example. Okay, so now you can search for the parameters you wanted to include in the user defined selection search. So I would like to take product ID, product internal. Okay, so simply drag and drop, and then let's also take division, drag and drop, and then take product type. Type code, and then also take profit center, profit center ID, and also take plan data. Okay, so now we have all the parameters, and here you need to define the extraction type. This means you want to extract the search results at message time, or you want to schedule as a background job and then you know, extract the search result. So I wanted to search in at runtime, so I put the extraction type as a direct. And if you have so much messages, then you can use you know, asynchronous search using a batch job. So once you finished with the settings, click on the check button and the configuration is consistent, then save it in the TR. And then go back Now click on the search. So now the search exists. So then the status of the search is inactive. You can activate it. And if you want to transport, you know, by logging into another transport request, you can click on the transport. And once you finish activating it, you can go back. And then you can able to simulate the process. You can expand it. And you can include the messages you wanted to search. For an example, one day or 1 week or 1 month, 1 month later messages. So you simply click on and then click on the search messages, and then you can click on the simulate. So now you can see the result. So now the user defined search works. So let's go back to SRT underscore money. And then we can search the messages based on the defined parameters. So close the screen. So I don't have sufficient messages in the development system. So I plan to transport all the changes to the quality system and perform the the search there. So let me open the quality system. And then before you click, perform the search, you need to index the data. So, so here you need to, take a note of it. If you face any issues with the user defined search, you can log an incident to SAP under this component. And for asynchronous message indexing, if it is a job based, then you can schedule this report. If it is a manual, then you can use this report to manually index. If you wanted to perform complete re-indexing, then you can use this report. So I wanted to manually index because I'm not going to use this search quite often. So go to SA38 and then index manually, and you can also put which message you wanted to index. So in this case, so go back to the screen and then start the index. So you can mention the date. For example, I put 8. And then you can start the index. So now the data are indexed. So now you can go to SRT underscore money. So this is the standard selection. Here you can mention the date when you wanted to search. You can also input sender information, receiver information. Once you finished with this, you click on this user defined selection. So here you can include the standard selection. Then you can search for the the plant ID or the material number. So I click on search. So search result exists. So you can also, you can include several parameters, and then you could, if you wanted to consider all the conditions, click on the messages matching all condition. Otherwise, messages matching at least one condition. So in this case, let me take product ID. Okay. I don't know the existing materials, so maybe I take division code as 10. You see the messages exist. So that's all, friends, about user defined selection parameters configuration. You can try it in your system. Of course, if you have better idea, you can share it with us. And as I mentioned, please take a note of it. You need to index if you wanted to search older messages. So thank you so much for watching our videos. We will come back with another video shortly. Until then, stay tuned and stay healthy.